Hi everyone and welcome to Imperfect Life Balance. My name is Marta and on my channel you can expect videos related to productivity, time management, and any topic related to work-life balance. So today we're gonna talk about how to find more time in your day to do the things that you want to do. So if you ever were in a situation where you said no to something that you really wanted to participate in or something that you wanted to do only because you did not have time for it, then this video is for you. We are all busy. We have a lot of things on our plates that we are responsible for. We have our jobs, we have our family, we have responsibilities at home, responsibilities within our community. And very often we want to do something for ourselves. Maybe it's a hobby, maybe it is a dream we're trying to pursue, or maybe it's something that we want to do, you know, maybe with a family member. And the thing that is stopping us is lack of time. So I want to talk to you about how we can all find time within our days. And the tips I'm going to share with you are something that has worked for me. This is how I was able to find the time to start a blog and start this channel. So before we dive in, I want to address something. Finding time in your day, I'm going to offer you some tips how you can do things a little bit differently to get some time. However, what I want you to keep in mind is that the idea of finding more time in your day to do the things that you want to do also needs to be done from a perspective that you don't want to keep adding to your plate. I don't want your days to look like you are a robot, just going from one task to another and just kind of keep going until you go to sleep. That is not the idea. So keep in mind that if you want to find more time for the things that you want to do, you will have to learn how to say no to some things in order to say yes to others. So keep that in mind as we're going through those tips. The first thing that we have to do is to actually figure out what we do during the day. I think that we tend to be biased on what we actually spend our time on. And that's because we are so used to our schedules and what we do that sometimes we either underestimate or overestimate the amount of time that we spend on a specific activity. So we might be overestimating how much time we actually commit to doing some reports at work or how much time we actually commit to cooking dinner. And we might be underestimating how much time we spend on social media or how much time we spend watching TV. So for that reason, the first step to figure out where to find more time in your day is to track what you are doing every day for about a week. So just get a piece of paper and keep writing away whatever you are doing. You can set timers for specific activities. The idea is just to be honest with yourself and not have this biased opinion from yourself what you are actually doing. Because I promise you, you will be surprised about some of the things that you're gonna discover when you actually take a look at it. So once you track your time for about a week, go back and look for things in your schedule that you can eliminate. Maybe you are volunteering somewhere and you are not enjoying that. Maybe you can get rid of that activity. Or maybe you look at your schedule and realize that you are spending about an hour and a half every day driving your kids to and from schools. So consider maybe you have somebody in your neighborhood who has kids at the same ages and you can do carpool. And maybe one week, you know, you can do the drop-off and pickup, and another week it could be the other person. And that way you're gonna save a lot of time within your week. The second thing you wanna take a look at is, can you do things more efficiently? So look at your mornings, look at your evenings. Do you have a routine that is working for you to make those times go more efficiently? Do you have systems in place to help you be more organized so you don't spend a lot of time either looking for things or trying to figure out how to do something when you have already done it before, but you just forgot how you had made that happen? So look at your days and figure out if there are any things that you are doing where you can get more efficient. The third thing you need to consider when you are looking at where you spend your time is where you can delegate some things. So maybe you took a look at how you spend your weekend and realized that you are spending, let's say, 3 hours going from grocery store to grocery store and getting all the food and other items, you know, to prepare you for the week ahead. You know, so there are different options you can consider. You can consider having your husband do that for you. You can consider doing some delivery of groceries. You can consider pickup of your groceries from a store, which is something that I personally do because I find it so efficient to just go on my computer, select what I want, and then pick it up when it's absolutely free, right? Why not do it? Or maybe you realize that on the weekends you also spend 2 to 3 hours every Saturday cleaning your house, giving it a deep clean. So this would be the area where you can say, okay, maybe I can involve my kids and my husband in helping me out. Maybe I can develop a schedule for myself so I do a little bit every evening. So on Saturday, I don't have to do everything. I can just do, you know, half an hour, for example, and that's how you gain that 2.5 hour back. Or maybe if you can afford it, you can hire someone to come into your house and clean the house for you. So consider all those different options when you look at where you are spending most of your time on the weekends and during the week. And you also need to take a closer look at your evenings and determine how much time you are doing on activities like watching TV, going on social media, things of that nature. Because you might realize that you are watching TV for 2 hours every single evening after your kids go to sleep. Which, if that is something that you truly enjoy and want to do, that is great. However, if you are serious about finding additional time to go after a dream of yours, maybe you want to pursue a hobby, maybe you have a dream of having a side business where you make jewelry. So you are really going to have to take a look and be honest with yourself what you want to do. Because if you are really wanting to pursue that dream, that you will have to say no to the TV. I'm not saying you cannot watch TV ever, but scale it down. Maybe dedicate a specific day of the week where you can binge watch your favorite shows. Or maybe, you know, just dedicate, you know, an hour each day to where you can actually relax and watch a show. And the other hour is to work on that potential business that you want to open. And the last area that I want to touch on is about being creative with how you find your time. So for example, there, you know, when I look at my schedule, what I do every day, there are two areas of my day where I try to incorporate some work on personal development and also on my blog and YouTube channel. So one of those areas is when my daughter is taking her bath. So she is 3 years old. So I still need to watch her as she's taking her bath. What she likes to do, she likes to play for about 30 minutes. So she's completely content by playing with herself. She wants nothing to do with me at that time. So instead of me just sitting there, I usually grab a book and I read a book that I on personal development. So that is how I get that, you know, additional 30 minutes in my day to do something for myself. Another area that I do, funny enough, also related to my daughter, she is still at that age. We're trying to work on that, but she is still at the age where she prefers that I sit next to her when she's going to sleep. And that usually takes an hour of my time. I used to use that time to watch something on YouTube or find a show to watch on Hulu or Amazon Prime. That's what I did for that hour of my time. And then when I started my blog and YouTube channel, that's when I can do some of the work. That's when I can do some edits on a video, when I can do some description. I can use that time better. There are days when I still like to use the time to watch a show, to relax, because let's be honest, I don't want to be burned out. There are some days when I just need to take a break and relax. So that's those days I will use to watch something. But most nights, I just work on my blog or YouTube channel because that is a dream that I have. That is my passion. That's something I want to pursue. So I use that time to work on it. So maybe you have times like that in your schedule. Maybe you commute to work, whether it's by car or by train. You know, you can listen to personal development books when you're on a train. You can listen to a podcast when you're driving. You can read a book when you are commuting to work on a train. use all those different gaps of time where you can do something for yourself. And the reason why it's so important to be creative with your time is because oftentimes we tend to think that we have to have this stretch of 5 hours of time for us to get something done. And let's be honest, most of us don't have that time. If you are working, if you are taking care of your kids, it's very hard to find that long of a time period where you can work on something. So instead, utilize those little periods of time to get something done, because progress is better than perfection, right? So you keep working on something and you're gonna get there. It's gonna take you maybe slower, but it's definitely gonna be faster than when you wait for that perfect moment, for that perfect day when you have a significant amount of time to work on something. That is all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, make sure you like this video and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my future ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.